Cal67 Gaming here, back with another long play of Le Tour de France. This is stage 20, and stage 20 marks my last day in the Alps. If you've been watching, you know that I currently hold a slender advantage of about a minute, I think, over Bardet. So obviously I've got the yellow jersey, I'd like to keep hold of that. This though being last day in the Alps, and Bardet being a mountain specialist, we've really got to keep an eye on him. Let's just go for the same as we always do. If I can, I'll just go as fast as I can. I do actually have a third thing that I have to do. If I see Bardet going, I'm going to have to go with him. There isn't enough of the race left to make up any lost time in this last mountain stage. So yeah, we'll go if he goes. Hopefully he won't. Quite a lot of stages he's actually tucked in behind me, but obviously with it getting near the end of the tour, he might try and break away from me and, you know, get back into contention for the yellow jersey himself. But we'll wait and see. I'll speak to you afterwards. And we'll go to stage 20.
Hello, cycling fans everywhere. If it's obvious that a win today will require the talons of a climber, it's not impossible to also imagine that everything will be settled on the final descent to Morzine, the finish of this alpine stage.
We're approaching the finish of the tour, guys. Everyone is tired, and everything will be decided now. It's all a question of mental strength. Acceleration at the head of the peloton.
His team is at full throttle. They have no one at the front. The peloton is riding hard. Stay well placed.
Thank you.
There's plenty of damage at the back of the peloton. It will be a long day in the saddle for those who fall behind.
The race starts the ascent of the Col de Zaraville, the first climb of the day. One minute for the breakaway. It's looking good. There will be 5 points for the first to the top. Figurehead of Czech cycling, Roman Kreuziger is a rider capable of outstanding performances on both hilly and mountain stages. He's an excellent puncher who also knows how to climb in the mountains. On the other hand, it's better for him that he finishes alone because his capabilities as a sprinter really are limited. One and a half minutes for the breakaway. It might just work. His best chance of victory is to try a breakaway from far out.
Front of the race is 2 kilometers from the summit.
Breakaway can't widen the gap.
Here's the positions over the last climb. Fall. It may create gaps. A teammate is down. A teammate is beginning to lose touch.
The Col de la Colombière is looming for the front of the race. It will be climbed by its southern side. The time gap between the peloton and the escapees is stationary. There will be 10 mountain jersey points for the rider who's first over the top.
The race is 2 kilometers from the summit.
Go, go, go! Auf geht's, die Ball!
counter-attack. Watch out. He's well-ranked on the climber standings.
It's not over. There's a counter-attack.
Here's the positions over the last climb.
The breakaway is increasing its lead over the yellow jersey, but there's no worry as it contains no big guns for the overall standings.
You must constantly try to shelter from the wind so as not to consume energy. This is what allows a rider to edge clear at the end of the race. When going downhill, the aerodynamic position is useful to increase speed without expending energy. Guys, don't forget to protect our leader. Communication is important. That's why we have team comm.
The gap isn't changing much.
I think his team has taken on the chase in order to place one of their guys in the breakaway.
The gap with the yellow jersey is melting away. The escapees will have difficulties going all the way.
Keep pushing!
The first riders have reached the intermediate sprint.
The first 15 score points at the intermediate sprint. The first will pocket 20 points. The breakaway is passing through the feed zone.
Keep pushing!
The ascent of the Col de Ramar will soon begin, nearly 14 kilometres long, with a slope at 7.1%. It's a real test to see who's in form today. The breakaway is increasing its lead over the yellow jersey, but there's no worry as it contains no big guns for the overall standings.
Auf geht's, Silber!
Auf geht's, Alberto!
there's not a lot going on.
The first rider to the top will score 10 more points towards the climber standings.
The front of the race is 2 kilometers from the summit. Here's the positions over the last climb.
Breakaway increases its lead on the yellow jersey group.
The end of the stage is not far off. Stay awake. It will soon start to move in the peloton. The peloton is riding hard. Stay well placed.
Yeah.
create gaps.
Hang on, keep pushing.
It is well on short climbs, but he can't really rely on his sprint qualities to hope for a win. He can ride for himself or serve as a luxury teammate. Time trial specialist, Tom Dumoulin also does well on mountain stages. He's a man to be watched. The advance of the lead group should be enough to carry it to the end. Here we are, the foot of the last climb of the day, the Col de Joux Plan. This is where a killer blow must be landed, because after the summit, it's downhill to Morzine. It's relatively short for a pass classified as all category, but it's very steep, with an average percentage of 8.5%. Thank you.
jumps on through that.
He's got his teammates riding because in front there's a rider who's dangerous to him in the overall standing. Breakaway looks to be increasing the pace at the front of the race. A teammate has just been dropped. You can't count on him any longer. Watch out! You'll soon have no more energy to attack. An attack! We've got to react! He's dangerous!
There will be 50, 40, 32, 28, 24, 20, 16, 12, 8 and 4 points for the first 10 to the top.
Front of the race is 2 kilometers from the summit.
Hang on, keep pushing.
The road will rise after the summit towards the Col du Rond Folie. It's only afterwards that the descent to Morzine actually begins. One kilometre from the summit, and one man has managed to get away on his own. If he doesn't mess up on the descent, it should be an easy win.
Here's the positions over the last climb.
Come on,
The stage may not be won on the descent, but it can still be lost on the many bends that lead to Morzine. The slightest mistake will be fatal. There's an attack at the head of the peloton.
He's being left behind. It's good news for the overall standings.
Less than 2 kilometers from the finish.
The breakaway is 1 kilometer from the finishing line.
We can say that the tour is going ideally for him. Here's the yellow jersey of this Tour de France. Let's hope for his sake that things go as well in the future, but for now, he can relish the moment.
Well, that's the Alps behind us. As I thought he might on that last climb, Bardet did go for it, and quite early on in the climb. I went with him, used up all my gel, for replenishing my energy. Really thought that I was in trouble, but it would appear that he used up all his energy as well, trying to break away from me. So we kind of got to the top with me just behind him. Stayed kind of just behind him all the way down that final descent, and actually increased my lead, only by a few seconds, but increased my overall lead over him. So that's the end of the mountains. There is one stage left, which we'll be doing next time. In the real Tour de France, the last stage is nothing more than a parade. There's no actual racing of cars. I'm guessing that's not going to be the case in the game, so I'll have to stay on my toes. But that's for next time. If you haven't already, give us a like, share and a subscribe, and I'll see you next time.